What's good, YouTube fam? Just wanted to make this quick video to update you guys about why I haven't been posting. And the reason is it's because I had issues for the past couple weeks with memory on my computer. It was like, I'm new to YouTube, right? So I'm not like so like, how do you say it? I'm not 100% sure of how you're supposed to download the videos you edit to your computer 100% so your memory doesn't fill up fast. I don't know if that makes sense, but yeah, my memory on my computer was filling up super fast, so I was trying to figure out how to, you know, download him to my external drive. That's what I thought I was doing the whole time, but I actually wasn't. I was downloading him to my computer, and that was filling up my shit, so, like, it was, like, not letting me download any more videos, yada, yada, yada. So, I'm gonna actually upload two videos today. I'm gonna upload the one that I didn't get to upload that I was trying to upload last time, and this, you know, more updated recent video. And these videos are gonna be based on my analysis videos I've been doing on AudioSD, right? And I'm really sorry, guys, because you guys could have really caught major pips off AudioSD based on my analysis, right? Because it literally shot up in the direction I was talking about, and I'll just let the video explain. But we're just gonna jump right in to the most recent analysis in this video. And by the time you're watching this video, you should already have watched last video. All right, guys, so I'm sorry about not being able to upload. I've had a lot of messages lately from people, you know, subscribers from my social medias. You guys have been hitting me up why I haven't uploaded any more content. And that's the reason, so I apologize once again. But let's jump right into this most recent analysis, guys. Hope you enjoy. Peace. Alright, guys, so here's AudioSD. It might look a little different now because back when we were talking about it, it was somewhere around this area over here. Here, let me put a box because last time we were talking about it, it was somewhere around this area because it had just broken a structure around here, right? And basically, there's a lot that's been happening with this pair. Overall, like we said on the previous video I did, it's a seller's market. Remember, I was talking about this trend line specifically right here. It did go above, but as you can see, this candle just tested. It closed on top of it. And as you can see, this next candle right next to it, the bearish candle right there, is potentially closing bearish once this daily candle closes. Right, so that would be a bearish engulfing, right? So if we have a bearish engulfing, which meaning that seller's momentum in a seller's market, respecting that trend line, even though it looks like it went over, that's only testing it. Okay, guys, if it doesn't break completely and close above it, it's only testing it. So this next daily candle is really gonna be something to watch for, right? Because we want it to close very strong, with seller's momentum. We want it to close like it is right now. Like, we want it to close. It'll probably retrace a little bit once it does close, but if it does close bearish, we definitely be looking to sell, right? So it did, you see this big correction, guys. So this right here, all these blue candles, bullish, 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 right? But it was just a correction because it never broke above the previous high, like lower high. Okay, so as you can see right here, lower high right here, let me do some illustration for you. Lower high right, gapped up, but it's still lower high, and then lower high right. So for it to been a bullish, in my opinion, right, for it to be bullish, it would have had to break and close above this high up here. Hold on, let me grab it. It would have to break above this high, right? Because that would be breaking structure. So it would have to do something like this. And if this bearish, if it doesn't close bearish, we could potentially see that because it would end up breaking this trend line. But we'll have to wait and see when the time comes. But if it would have to do something like this. For it to go bullish, in my opinion, right, guys? Break above it,
and then continue up, okay? But since we're still okay for bearish, this closed bearish, I'm expecting seller's market, okay? I'm expecting it to drop to this area right here. Why? Because the same bias as the previous video, guys. If you look, right, if you zoom out, three touches on this. Three touches, right? So we have one right there. So that would be the third touch right here. The other one's over here in this area. Down here, right? Down there. But so yeah, so if I would expect bearish to continue, you know, taking over and drop down to this level. So targets, long-term target to 73,300 area, right? It could keep going, you never know. But as of now, we're just going with the flow. This was just a huge correction on the daily. On the 4 hour, it was a bullish move, right? It had broken structure right over here. And we had talked about it when it was over here. So I was letting you guys know it was just going bullish for a correction, right? Because every time frame needs a correction. For example, right? For example, these are corrections. I'll put boxes on top of all the corrections in the market, because the market can't just go one way. The market has to flow, right? It has to flow in a way. It can't just go up, 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 up. It has to go up, down, up, down, up, down. You know, basically what I'm saying is, guys, there's corrections in the market. They are going to happen. So see these blue candles be under the red candles right there? Those are corrections, right? So this big ass move right here, this big blue, was a correction. So you see what happened after the correction was done on each occasion. Up, drop, up, drop, up, drop, up, potentially drop, okay? So that's what I'm looking at, guys. That's exactly what I'm looking for AUDUSD. If this closes bearish, I'll be looking for, I'm actually already in based off the 4 hour time frame, but I would wait for confirmation for this low to be broken, right? So I'm wanting it to break this low, something like this. So price is right there. And then like that, okay? Exactly like that. That's what I'm looking at, guys. That's what I would want to ideally happen. Break, close below the low, which would be breaking structure. But we just have to go with what the market's telling us at that point in time. If you aren't following my social media, you guys should follow that, because I called this sell way up here for AUDUSD. So be sure to follow me on my Facebook and Snapchat, because I call a lot of stuff on those. And guys, if you guys have any questions, you guys, my email's in the description also. You guys can feel free to email me. But that's what I'm looking for AUDUSD.
All right, guys, so that was my analysis on AUDUSD. I hope you guys enjoy. And like always, never take my analysis 100%. You know, we just have to adapt to market conditions, right, guys? And just go with what the market is telling us and just flow with it, all right? So I hope you guys enjoyed once again. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace.